Our bell, the Tarpley bell, was cast in the same foundry, the Whitechapel Bell Foundry in London, where the Philadelphia Liberty Bell was cast.
Our bell is lighter, it's smaller, it isn't cracked, and we still ring it every day. It was given to us by James Tarpley, who was a merchant further down by the Capitol. We're in the uptown end of town. The business end was downtown, so that's down by the Capitol.
Tarpley gave the bell in 1761.
I believe that there was an earlier bell. I've seen records that Governor Spotswood took a bell off a pirate ship.
Had it put on a frame in the churchyard so they could call people to worship and they could sound the alarm. When the tower and steeple were added in 1769, the old bell was given to Benjamin Powell, the undertaker, which means he was the builder. They spent an enormous amount of money on the tower. Benjamin Powell is the one who constructed the tower and a steeple to house the bell up at the top. The steeple area is geometrically balanced. Some people living in Williamsburg at the time said it resembled the Emperor of Morocco's pigeon house. Other people thought it looked like a Muslim house of worship, and they happily published these opinions in the Virginia Gazette.
It is a beautiful piece, the steeple. The bell that's inside it is a very important piece of our story because it rang out not just to call people to worship, but it rang out if there was a fire, it rang out if there was a disaster.
It rang out when a parishioner died and likely rang when those hated stamp taxes were repealed as we're moving into the excitement of the revolution and we're moving into the years where everything starts to change for Bruton Parish and the Church of England in Virginia.
It pealed when Edmund Pendleton's resolution for independence was passed at the Capitol. They hauled down the Great Union, put up the Grand Union. They handed the paper to a horseback rider and he rode off to Philadelphia saying, Virginia says go for independence. It rang for the end of the battle at Yorktown.
It rang for the Peace of Paris in 1783, ending the conflict with Great Britain.
It has rung for every treaty from every war. It rang when the Constitution was passed. It rings every day now. The Tarpley family owned a store further down by the Capitol. They sold a great deal of linen, fabric of all sorts for people's clothing. They were not in business very, very long. But that particular property has been a tavern, it's been a general store, it's been several other things, but it's always a place of business. And Tarpley was probably not the wealthiest man in town by any means, but he felt an enormous responsibility to the church, and giving the church a bell was a big statement about who he was. On Constitution Day, we ring it. We have little children come usually and ring it. We allow little children, or we invite little children to ring it every day for noonday prayer. And it's a great treat to actually ring it. Years ago, it would swing. Now it's stationary so that a hammer strikes it, so we won't do any damage to it. How you ring the bell says a lot about what you're trying to say. After a wedding, when I'm ringing it, I tend to do it pretty quickly, so that it's a joyful sound. Very often I'm able to ring it after a funeral, and I do that in a very solemn, measured tone because the voice of the bell tells you exactly what you need to hear. So Virginia's Liberty Bell is a very special piece of Bruton Parish.